Deke, you okay? You don't sound like yourself.
It's nothing. You know, I just let this drifter get the drop on me. Lucky for me, she was out of ammo.
You let her go, didn't you?
Okay, yeah, fuck. Yes, I let her go.
One of these days, Deke, that coat of yours is gonna get you killed.
Yeah, well, something's gonna do it, right? Does it matter what? Deacon out. Jesus, what a climb. All right, let's see what the hell Boozer's talking about. We're right. Someone's on the mountain. I see smoke from their campfire.
Son of a bitch. I knew I heard something. Where are they? I'm gonna head out there.
No, goddammit, Boozer. Gotta get your arm healed up so we can ride the hell out of here. I'll take care of him.
Shit. It's just... I'm going a little stir-crazy here, Dick.
Just try to stay awake in case they head your way. Deacon out. Oh, Jesus. You gotta get in shape. Almost there. Yeah, come on, keep going. Almost there. Oh, shit's killing me. Could make something out of this. St. John to Copeland's camp. It's done. The radio tower's locked down. I've restored your radio uplink.
Copy that. You may not see the value in St. John, but Radio Free Oregon is the only thing keeping us from turning into savages.
Now, Cope, the only thing keeping us from turning into savages is about 9 square meals. Try going hungry for 3 days. There's no such thing as a starving patriot.
Well, sir, I hope to God you're wrong about that. Copeland out.
Radio Free Oregon. Jesus, what have I done? One of the camps can use this. Okay.
Boozman, you awake? I'm heading to that camp you spotted north of the mountain.
I heard gunshots. Might be an ambush camp.
I'll find out when I get there. Deacon out.
dumbass grave. I keep forgetting it's so close to O'Leary Mountain. Don't ask me how. Micro recorder. Hello.
Field 1381. Agent Sinclair reporting. I'm at Corpse Disposal Site 13 Beta. Supervising the unloading and disposal of cargo. You never get used to the smell, do you? Trains have been running nonstop, and all the current sites are almost to capacity.
Who's
I've
man?
Been erects to open up more
set up along
federal
the
land
tracks.
Being counters of DC have stopped.
Kill everyone
my
calls. Of bitches.
Yes, they have more important business.
This is kind of the plan. Deacon out.
Something's going on.
Side note to Perkins. I was right, asshole.
Get low on ammo.
Yeah, I know we there fucked up partially. Plotting the site here instead of over at site 13 Alpha, but
okay.
Worked out. Remember, I had to argue my ass off to keep this site in our back pocket. I knew it was going to be mad. But no one believed me.
Shoot it! Shoot it!
I guess you all believe me now.
Thank you.
that's the last of them. Stay the hell off O'Leary Mountain.
Boozer, it's done. Squatter camp. They won't be doing any more killing on O'Leary Mountain.
Good. Deke, I should have been there. To help, I mean, I...
Shit. Just rest up, Booze Man. Rest up. We're riding north as soon as your arm heals. You got that?
Yeah, I hear you. Boozer out.
Squatters. God damn it. They were waiting for me. Topping off.
You heading out?
Yeah, I'm gonna ride up to the cemetery and see if I can find Leon's stash.
Sorry. What was that?
Rest up, Boozer. We're heading north as soon as you can ride. What's going on, Cope?
A man come in, drugged, out of his mind, shot the place up, then he just took off. Manny said his bike's got a red tank on it, and he was wearing some kind of motocross helmet, silver.
Okay, if I go now, I might be able to catch up to him.
I want him alive, Deke.
Alive?
Alive. You catch this man, then radio me. We'll fetch him and hang the bastard right from that limb. It's time...
Coming in my camp, killing folk like we were out in the shit.
What's going on, Cope?
A man come in, drugged, out of his mind, shot the place up, then he just took off. Manny said his bike's got a red tank on it, and he was wearing some kind of motocross helmet, silver.
Okay, if I go now, I might be able to catch up to him.
I want him alive, Deke.
Alive?
Alive. You catch this man, then radio me. We'll fetch him. Hang the bastard right from that limb. It's time we start showing these drifter sons of bitches that we have law and order in this camp. No offense meant to yourself.
None taken. I'll find them. Boozer, no, you're gonna get yourself killed. You gotta wait till your whole brother. I'm over here anyway, so I'll take care of the mess, okay?
Yeah, okay. Thanks, Deke.
Deke, wait till tonight.
He's trapped, gotta help.
Or take him up while it's still light out. There'll be more of them, but they won't be as strong. Boozman, no. You know, I wouldn't ride north without you.
Yeah, I know. I just kinda out of it.
You're gonna be okay.
You're gonna die out here. I know of a camp where it's safe.
Camp? I'll go. Where? Show me!
Peaceful Lake. Mark Copeland. It's safe there.
Thank you so much for stopping. I was so dead. I was never getting out of there. Thank you.
Yeah, let them know it was Deacon St. John. They know me.
Now just keep running. Stay off the road.
Deke, you there? Did you say you were heading north?
Uzman, no. You know I wouldn't ride north without you.
Yeah, I know. I just kinda out of it.
Well, third degree burns will do that to you.
Hey, man. So, take care of Alvarez. Deke, means a lot to me.
Take care of her, Boozer. Just get some rest. Deacon out.
Tell him to swing by and say hello to Cope. I would much appreciate it. Copeland out.
Interesting.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Who remembers the skid rows of this great country? People living on the streets in boxes and tents because they couldn't afford the American dream. Fall for this very country. Only to have the feds forget about it as soon as they were done.
Another infestation
zone. PTSD. It doesn't stand for post-traumatic stress disorder. It stands for put them soldiers down. Well, we're all homeless now. Living in the wilderness in the way of our forebears. The feds used to think we needed their welfare and handouts to survive. We showed them how wrong they were. What we need now is a strong will. Determination and trust in.
Need that? Weeping Angel. This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon?
All right, where?
Maybe in one of these. That's interesting. Got it. Now I just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this to.
Boozer! Boozman, are you listening? Oh, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me and acted like I wasn't even there.
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing.
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. Don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid.
What did you drop?
Hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
Getting hungry?
I'm now.
Starting.
Field note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. That us?
No, it's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson. Your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
They're sleeping like babies. And I asked if you were going in. Say I was.
These subjects are not sleeping, they're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like it was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. But not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was fubar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
I think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Secret caves. Yeah, right, like anyone gives a damn.
Well, that was a lot of goddamn freakiness.
Yeah. A few dozen at least.
Jesus, this is taking forever.
I don't think forever's a long time.
We're pulling out! Hold up! Hold up! Move through! Go, go, go!
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
When we rode out of Farewell, the Nero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
What are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. You wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? There, the whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look, I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
I'm not, Boozer, I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with murders. Those who saw the blood of bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know, because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came driving cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon.
don't believe the lies.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving, because if anyone had found your unmarked band, they'd have blown it to hell. Just so we wouldn't have to listen to your bullshit radio free organ. Scrap. Nest. Whew. Gotta be right around here. Which way? You're mine now. Gotta take a closer look. What do we got? Still got this.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Black helicopters have been spotted in the skies. You might have seen them. Heard them. Thought you were losing your mind. Thought Nero died out here like the rest of them, caving under their own stupidity. But no, like I said, they've been lying in wait all this time till they can crawl up out of their holes and reclaim this world. But it ain't happening. Not on my watch. And don't go running towards them thinking they're gonna save your ass. Any man wearing a uniform worth a damn died more than 2 years ago. These men, they'll shoot you on sight. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Jesus. Cope, they're not trying to reclaim shit. You don't have a damn clue what you're talking about. Except, yeah. They will shoot you on sight. Lucky guy. Come back later. Finish burning out these nests. Hello, squatter camp. The sons of bitches have been setting up ambushes around here, yeah? You like killing drifters, is that it? How do you like it now? That's it. You're done. How do you like that, huh? Being ambushed, you like that? You murdering sons of bitches.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. It's the Wild West again. And some men are acting like law and order are a thing of the past. But last I checked, this is still the United States of America. And in America, the right of property shall not be infringed. We have the right to claim territory, to hold it, and to defend it. Sure, we took this land from the Indians. No point in rewriting history, but we took it by force. And force is the only thing that will move us now. We're not gonna roll over for a bunch of bullies. If the feds, or rippers, or marauders think they're gonna come rolling into my wilderness, they got another thing coming. The strongest survive, the strongest take, and the strongest will succeed. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Listen to Cope, law and order are a thing of the past. What the hell are you talking about? But yeah, you got a point about force being the only thing that matters now. Force and a lot of goddamn ammo.
All right, let's see if they got an underground bunker around here.
Here's the hatch. Yeah, knew you had one.
What's this? A map? Notes? Yeah, okay.